Testing, testing. Alright, back in the game, and now it's pick. Okay, that's what it was. Thank you. You have to run Streamlabs as an administrator. But OBS, you can just run it. Yeah, I've never had that one happen. That was weird. I used to use Streamlabs a while back when I was streaming different games before, and it never had that issue. But it just updated Streamlabs a crap ton because I've been using OBS Studio for a long time now. Yeah, I prefer OBS Studio. Some of the stuff in Streamlabs is kind of nice because it's a lot easier to work with, but you can do a lot with OBS. I don't know. I'll probably end up going back to OBS, to be honest, but we'll see. Alright, yeah, okay, still picking up the microphone and I locked in the window, so alright, that's good. Oh, that's right, I was gonna go test the ripple. Took 4 racks, right? Yeah, 4 racks. And I'm totally speeding on the taxiway. Oh, good. The chat showed up on the window, too. That's good. That's something else I want to test. Thanks for typing. And yeah, no problem. Thanks for hanging out. Have yourself a good night. Thanks for the follow.
Altitude. Altitude. Altitude.
Oh yeah, that's a new one. Saw that picture profile. Yeah. Saw that the profile picture I had up there was when I had the little short beard thing. Now I've just got the full goatee, so figured I'd switch it up. Alright, I'm gonna switch over to, I don't know, probably hog it. Now that it seems like Streamlabs is working alright. Still looks like Streamlabs uses a little bit more CPU and RAM than OBS Studio.
Temperature 21.7 Celsius. Altimeter 29.93. Remarks 1013 hectopascal. QFE 29.78 or 1008. End information Foxtrot. This is a Napa Vityazevo information Foxtrot. Runway in use is 22. Wind 1.
All right, what do we got going on? All right, so they've already moved the line forward quite a ways. Oh, look at that old school SU-25, not the T model, the old model, where you gotta fire big fat rockets through the HUD. That's awesome. Kudos to him. All right, so we are just going to come up here, and we're going to take out, we're going to go after these, one of these strike, what the hell is this? Or we're going to go right over here and check this out first. And then we'll go east. So we're going to go to the northeast, then we'll go east from there if there's nothing. Well, there's something there, or the circle wouldn't be there, so we'll go check that out and see what we can see. Although I imagine one of these 400 strike eagles going over there should take care of the one spot here, but we'll see. So, we'll take the Maverick loadout.
Request rearming.
Copy. Rearming complete.
One, bra, 078470 at 26,000 hot.
Is there two Fulcrums up there already? I see some friendly Hornets. That's weird that there'd be some Fulcrums this close to our base past all of this. That's gotta be something weird. That can't be right. Hey, those strike eagles took off and they did not go blow this point up, so I guess we'll just go still check it out. I wonder why they left it. You know, it's probably one unit in a fucking tree line or something. But that looks pretty void of big forested areas unless it's right here. Or it's in the buildings or something. We'll see. We'll have a look. I'm gonna go up with an A model though, so it's not like I can use a targeting pod to get a good look at everything around there from a safety distance, but we'll see what we can do. Can't believe those fulcrums.
Nova traffic bell, 1 second runway 22 straight out. Over traffic, level one, wheels up, push attack, mark on.
Tusk, 1-2, request startup. Nap traffic, skip mark 1-1, taxi to emergency.
Ah, God, Hoggett's always windy. Look at that. It's like they always have to make the wind kind of harsh. It's never like a light day on Hoggett where you can just land when you need to. Napa traffic, FUBAR 11 taking runway 22 for a northern departure. Napa traffic, FUBAR 11, active clear.
Traffic clear, where would you do?
Well, that's two targets down, including a Tunguska. That's a good start.
Altitude.
Shit. Sorry. Oh, got a T-72. Now we're going to have to play the dangerous game and get some altitude and try to see if we can spot anything from up high. Well, what is with that lag? And of course the cloud cover is going to not allow me to go up higher than I want to go. Well, maybe, we'll see. Damn cloud cover. It's gonna hose me. Well, there might be, the clouds might not be over the target area there. Let's see if there's a SAM over there though. Doesn't look like it on the RWR, but we'll see. Oh shit, server's restarting in 5 minutes. Wonder why my Maverick was not locking onto that sucker. Must be a man pad. Well, I got a few of those targets until I decided to go for a suicide wild weasel run there with the servers going down in 5 minutes. It was worth it. If that missile would have missed me, I saw the smoke trail. I could have dropped those CBU-97s right on them. It's a lot harder when you don't have a TGP.
Request refueling. Request
Copy.
Rearming.
Copy. Refueling complete. Rearming complete.
Request refueling. Request
Copy.
Rearming.
Copy. Refueling complete.
Request refueling. Request
Copy.
Rearming.
Copy. Refueling complete. Rearming complete.
Oh, thanks for the follow. The thing that stumped me this time when I was trying to set up Streamlabs was it wasn't doing any of my hotkeys for microphones or anything when I was in game. But I didn't know you had to launch Streamlabs in as administrator. That's all I did to fix like half the problems I was having, because I used to use OBS Studio for everything, and I'm trying Streamlabs out, and I was like, what the hell? Nothing's working. Right. I mean, that's why I wanted to try Streamlabs, because they got a lot more features added into it that you don't have to kind of create out of thin air like on OBS. But I was worried about how many resources it's going to chew up, because when I do stuff like DCS, DCS eats RAM, like, no matter how much you have. So I was worried if I tried to stream with Streamlabs, it might become a problem. But it seems to be fine so far. This is a multiplayer server. I'm not having any issues. The RAM's a little bit higher and the CPU's a little bit higher doing it with Streamlabs, but it's not too much worse. It's not that big of a deal so far. When you followed, did it show like a little picture? Did it do the little, I know it played the sound, but did it show like, I noticed when you typed in chat, it's showing the chat on there like it's supposed to. Clouds. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's just the default image. I don't have anything special in there yet. I literally just started messing with Streamlabs tonight. Trying to get my own... I put my own splash screens in there. I just took my OBS files that I used for my original OBS and slapped them over here. But I didn't have, like, alert boxes and stuff on my OBS. I didn't have the chat box thing on my OBS. I was trying to figure out how to do it myself, but I wasn't having much luck. Thank you, though. It's a work in progress. 44 miles. Unfortunately, the optics on a Maverick warhead does not see 44 miles. Oh, the wind's picking up. Oh, if I was in the Thunderbolt 2 with a TGP, I'd be able to spot it from 44. I mean, half the time if I'm on like something like Hoggett or in the Caucasus Mountains, if you take off from Maykop, there's usually SAMs and stuff to the northeast, and I can usually pick them up on the TGP if I slew it over there from about 40 miles out. At like 28 miles, I'm counting serial numbers. When you kick it over to narrow. But I'm in a A model, so all I can do is kind of ghetto FLIR by using the Maverick itself. The pre-upgrade. The Desert Storm model. If I was able to take up a Thunderbolt 2 on this mission in this map, shit, I'd be able to just program in the GPS coordinates from while sitting on the runway and already had the TGP slewed right to where the boat is. Surprised I'm actually not getting an RWR warning. This is weird. I just completed the last mission on the Burning Skies server, so it reset the mission, but the only thing that was spawned back was this boat. The map is clean now, like it didn't actually reset the mission. But it did reset the server, and then this boat was there, so I don't know. I'm gonna go check it out. There it is. Is that an aircraft carrier? That looks like an aircraft. That is an aircraft carrier. So, where's their patrols? I'd expect to see some, like, Su-27s or some MiG-29s or something in the air. I don't think the server fully reset. They should be shooting me full of holes right now. Yeah, it's the that, yeah, the carrier with the verted runway, which is crazy. I was just messing around on this server. I'm not that familiar with it. Maybe after the server resets, it takes so much time for them to launch. Last time I was on this server, like 3/4 of it was red because it was all taken, and we had to take all the other spots back. No, I haven't checked out Gray Flag yet. I fly around a little bit on Enigmas, depending on the map that he's using at the that day. I do a decent amount of Hoggett. I do custom missions. I've actually only been flying in DCS for a very short period of time, so I'm just getting into it. I have flight knowledge, just not DCS knowledge. This is a little bit new for me. Yeah, thank you. I am loving it. Yeah, something's wrong. There's no air defenses or anything off of that carrier. They should have at least normal cap in the air right now. That's weird. So I'm going to assume there's something wrong with the server reset when the mission was completed. I don't know. I'm going to pump some Mavericks into it and see if it does anything. Because that ain't going to really hurt that carrier. I'm going to piss them off. Oh, there we go. I got a 2,000 pounder. That should do a little bit of damage. It's taking damage. £2,000 on the deck and it did like 1% damage. That's hilarious. See if I can broadside it with some heat rockets. It's on fire though, that's a good sign. Better be on fire, 2,000 pounds. Yeah, well, I don't have any. If I had the Thunderbolt 2, yeah, grab some, let's see, that would be a GBU-31, 2,000-pound JDAM with a penetrator. Bunker Buster. Actually, I should go for the... Wow, those Oh wait a minute. That was something on it. Oh wait, that was the mission. Holy shit, you're kidding me. That's hilarious. So I just beat the server mission already. It was just that. That's hilarious. So I just won this multiplayer server twice in a row. Because the other one, when I came in, there was just one spot with some trucks and some AAA. And I just went in there and took them all out. And it won the server again and reset. Those rockets must have taken out the command center. That's where I was aiming. Because it went from like 10% damage to 95% damage. Those heat rockets fucked it up. That's hilarious. Now the server's going to reset. Yep, there it goes. That's hilarious. Mission one, take out an aircraft carrier before they can actually launch anything. Well, at least they wouldn't be able to launch any planes after I put 6 Mavericks on the deck. That would have fucked the deck up enough to where they couldn't launch, probably. Well, I don't know. It's not like that aircraft carrier had catapults. No, it did it again. Now it's still all blue. What's going on? Now there's nothing. Oh wait, there it is. Yeah, that's what I think it is. I think when the server starts, it randomly puts an enemy aircraft carrier out there, and then it'll start launching missions to. Because every time I've been on this server, it's usually mainly red, but that must take time or something. So that's kind of cool. Except now that the server's over, it's uncool. So I don't know how long you gotta wait before it actually spawns back with stuff to do. I don't know. I'll switch servers and then check on it later and see how long it took. What time is it? It's 1:40 in the morning. What map does Gray Flag use? Did you say Gray Flag or Blue Flag? Heck, is it locking up on me? It's not responding. That's weird. I'm gonna put up my Be Right Back screen and maybe restart DCS. Doesn't seem to be doing anything. I think my whole computer is slowly locking up. This is weird. I wonder if that's a problem with Streamlabs in DCS. Seems to be fine after I, you know, Control-Alt-Deleted out DCS and closed it out. I'm gonna have to make a clip out of that mission to put over on my YouTube. When the server resets, get out to the aircraft carrier right away and take it out with a single A-10A. That's just fucking funny. HEAT heat rockets into the bridge of the aircraft carrier, and then a whole bunch of 30 millimeter explosive high incendiary rounds. They're like, yeah, we give up. You keep that Burt to yourself. All right, we'll see if that fixed that. What am I looking for? Gray flag? Oh, they've only got Syria or Marianas up right now. Oh, this will take a moment too. Hoggett usually takes a while to load. Is the sound not coming through now? Streamlabs just doesn't pick it up very well. Oh yay, a night mission. I really didn't want to do a night mission tonight. It's kind of a pain in my ass in this model.
Request rearming. Copy. Rearming complete.
297.
Did that guy just burn me? Did he just fly right over my head and afterburn me? No way. You're shitting me. That's friggin' ridiculous. All right, we'll take Alpha from Cobaletti. Says the SRS is connected, but there's nobody on the channels. That's weird.
Refueling complete. Rearming complete.
Uzi, 4-1. Overlord, 1-1. Bra, 340. 4-100. At 18,000. Hot.
Thank you.
Cobaletti traffic, crossing runway, heading to runway 7. Cobaletti traffic, FUBAR 11 taking runway 7 for a northern departure. Cobaletti traffic.
Traffic, Tryin flight, taxiing to runway 31.
Cobaletti traffic, FUBAR 11, clear the active. Windy. Of course it is. It's a multiplayer server. It's always got to have a huge crosswind. Alright, let's go hit this first patrol point up here. Let's see what we got. Flaps up. Taxi lights off.
Atumi traffic, Tryin flight, taking runway 31 for departure.
if I ever get rich, I'm going to make my own DCS server, and I'm going to have the wind go from calm to extra calm.
Tumi traffic. Tryin flight clear of runway 31 heading north.
Seeing as how we don't have a targeting pod in this model, we will have to use a Mark 1 eyeballs. Want to get close enough to where you can make out the targets, but not close enough to where they can shoot bullets in your face. Rule number one, don't get shot, especially in the face. I don't actually see anything there. Oh, it's farther down. I thought it was just because the shadows from the clouds were playing tricks with my eyes, but no, they're farther down. No, wait, it says they're right there. I see them now, there they are. Calm down. Give me a break. That's not over G. That's not even close. Well, it's a little close because I got a full load, but still. Do a nice, gradual, clean, coordinated turn. Huh. All right, we're going to mark it and do a CCRP then. do this proper. Pickle. Are they just not going off now? Oh, there they go. There they go. Two destroyed. Oh, there should be more than that. Come on. I wish I could drop 105s from this airframe. There's three destroyed. Keep going. Keep going. Man, it should have got more than three destroyed. There was a bunch of them there. That's weird. That thing should, those things, those skeets should fling out pretty far. You know what? We're gonna go down here and take care of this stuff in between these buildings then. I got 197 left, so we're gonna parachute them right into that little area in between the buildings where all that stuff is. Then I got a couple of rock eyes. Pickle. Nothing? Okay, there we go. I was like, where are they coming? They should have been fusing by now. Oh, that's got a lot. Oh, yeah. Keep going. There you go. That's the stuff. Good secondaries, too. That's how we CBU. Got two rock eyes. They went in a little early, it looks like.
pull up.
Oh, lag. Oh, come on. Sure, it's sleep-ish. I deal with sleep-ish every night. My problem is because of my disabilities, I have to take medicine, and the medicine keeps me awake. So I just sleep for small spurts early in the morning. Ah, yes. Son, the human body can survive on 45 minutes of sleep. They don't tell you the part where they say, but only for a little bit. You missed it earlier. I was on the Burning Sky server, and we won the mission, and I was able to take out the Russian aircraft carrier with my A-model Warthog. The 2,000-pounder on the deck didn't do a whole lot. The Mavericks hurt the deck a little bit and lit it on fire, but then I put, I think it was 28 heat rockets into the bridge, and about 400 rounds of 30 millimeter and it popped it. Gonna have to clip that out for the YouTube channel later. Well, probably tomorrow. Yeah, I was thinking about broadsiding it with the heat rockets to see if I could punch some holes, but it's like, well, that doesn't do nothing. Might hurt the bridge pretty much, though. So I just put them all right into the bridge and the stack. And then followed it up with, you know, high explosive incendiary 30mm, which is just devastating to whatever it touches. Interesting lag.
Overlord 1-1, Bra 324, 4-1-20 at
Oh, there we go. There we go. 30 millimeter. Yeah, that's a little cruel, but I don't go for airborne targets very often, so gotta make sure I can still track a target. It was hard for a second because I had a little spot on my monitor. I'm like, is that a damn plane? I kept looking at that spot and seeing it as a plane.
Traffic, Tryin flight inbound. Traffic, Tryin flight on final runway 31. Runway 25, correction.
God, look at that wind. It's always got to be windy.
Altitude.
And that is how we do that. Well, that wind kept trying to buffet me real bad at the end there. Didn't even have to really flare, the wind was flaring me. Hey, Commie, how's it going? You missed it. I soloed an aircraft carrier with a hog on the Burning Sky server. I'll have to, probably tomorrow in the afternoon, I'll edit and do some highlight cuts of that Burning Skies server. Because that was just hilarious, taking out an aircraft carrier. I must have just got lucky with crits, because I fired every heat rocket I had into the bridge of that aircraft carrier, and it went from like 10% damage to 90-something percent real fast. Oh shit, I forgot to look at my score. Oh well, doesn't matter. I blew stuff up, I ran out of ammo, I landed, I had no bullets in me. Score is good. Oh wow, look at that. Hog at Georgia at War has only got 3 people left on it tonight. Damn. Oh, it might just because they just did a reset. I'm gonna call it for tonight though. So the Streamlabs worked decently for the most part after I got some of the kinks worked out. It wasn't dropping frames, it doesn't look like. It does bounce the CPU a little bit, but not too bad. I did get all my splash screens put over here onto Streamlabs and some other shit. Well, thanks for flying with me, everybody who's still here. Thanks for hanging out. Clips and streams all go to YouTube as well, because Twitch deletes everything super fast. And I will see everybody probably tomorrow. Have yourselves a good night or day or whatever you got going on. Take it easy.